All right, guys, we're back. Thanks so much for sitting through that break. And now we're just going to hop right back into where we were at. So let's go ahead and get started here. Okay, so I ran a test right before break. And the test was simply to see if we could pass in a DS map as a parameter and then on the other side pull out things like objects that we passed in. Well, I did think of a way to do that when we ran it, but we may have to be a little bit creative with how we do it, and I'll show you what I mean by that. I'm looking for the exact script. I don't think I have it open still, so I'm going to open it back up. Weapon check, and instead of doing a, it tried to pull in object 3, and instead of doing that, doing it that way, here's what we'll do. Don't need to worry about this. Get that guy out of the way for a minute. And here's where we wrote it in the step event. And let me think about this for a minute. I think I can do it that way, and I'm going to look at that real quick. I believe object get name returns a string. Returns the name of the object, returns the name of the specified object as defined in the resource tree. Let me look at this one over here as well. Returns the index number of the object that the instance has been made from. Object name, object get name, the and pass in the index. That's fine. Looks like it's more of a real type. This read-only variable, it's a variable. Okay, and then the other thing, asset get index. I believe you can just pass in a string. Returns the unique index of the game asset within the given game with the given name, and so you pass in a string, and it will then get the object. All right. So in this case, so this may I think this will be fairly easy initially, at least with these two items, but this may be a little bit. Actually, I do see part of a problem here, which is that wasn't an object, and I would like to test it this way first. Apparently, I just didn't even have that set as a correct asset index. So first of all, I'm going to test it this way. It seems to have gotten past the first one anyways, because it errored out at object enemy 3. So let's just see this one more time, guys, and see what we got here. This might be really good because then I wouldn't have to worry about the conversion from script to from step to script. Let's try that.
Mission 1, Death at Dusk, go!
Okay, it looks like we got it. I'm looking at the debug window right here, and it looks like it's outputting correctly based on what we are passing in. I think it is. So really only one way to check, and that's to pass this over to the script at this point. So again, I was referring to this data right here. This is output in the basically a step event that's passing it all over to here over and over again. So we might be in a really good place. There is like no volume to be heard until the game starts. Language? Game Maker language. GMS Pro. So can you hear me right now, WViper 3? Can you hear me just talking? Is it, So WViper, okay, cool, you can hear me, good. All right, thanks, Chris, for letting me know that you can hear me. All right, so this is really, really good news for us. I'm going to close out of there, and I think we're good to just keep building this the way that we have it. We're gonna at least try, and instead of script weapon collision, we'll pass it into instead of script weapon check, we'll pass it into collision. I'll delete this property, or sorry, this script that we're not going to use, and then let me look at a little bit more related to TS map. Okay, that's fine. I don't need that. Destroy, write, read, find value. So you pass in a key, finds the key specified and returns the paired value from the DS map. So DS map, find map value, ID, and key. Perfect. So we do have an argument, and the argument is var arg0 equals argument 0. And I'm going to comment this information out right here just momentarily. And we're going to have to do some rework, of course, of this. So arg0 includes several different keys here, and we're going to have to get them out in this manner. So we'll just go, let me see here, arg0 map DS weapon map. And I think actually we can keep this and just set this up in a little bit of a unique way compared to the way we had it. And this is good because we'll just say DS map find value, and we will pass in the weapon map and the key, which will be object weapon. I'm gonna make the keys a little bit shorter here, and I'll make notes over here what they are. Key, object, weapon. Key, object, enemy. This will just make it easier, so I don't have to use the full string each time I'm trying to get it. X pos and Y pos, those are small enough to leave alone. OW, and I'll just say it again here, object weapon. Argument 2 is, I'm hearing you fine by this. So are you merging all the enemies into one script or all the weapons? Right now, Chris, I'm merging all of the weapons into one script, but I'm only working on one weapon at the moment. And more specifically, I am merging all the collisions for the Vulcan Cannon bullet into one script. After I get that all into one script, then I can add all the weapons to pass through the same script. So yeah, that's pretty much it. That should make sense. So then we will say, I'm trying to be careful how I do this because I don't want to try to set a value if it doesn't exist. So I'm wondering if I can just basically let me see here. Okay, I've got it. So instead of doing that there, I'll pull this down here, similar to the way I had it, and say, if not is undefined, I think I can do that. And this is probably an easier way to check without having to pull back the value. Create, add, clear. I don't really see a way to check to see if something exists or not. The map exists, just checks to see if the map actually exists. Oh, here we go. This is even better. I was incorrect with that. So we'll just use that. DS map exists. And pass in the both of those values, the map index and the key that we're looking for, and then we'll say arg0 equals ds map exists dswm. So we're doing this in a little bit of a different way, and it'll still get the job done exactly the way we need to. So this one, similar to how we had it yesterday, we'll just go ahead and fill all these out, overwrite these variables. Instead of OW, we'll make it OE. This one we'll call exposition. Let's just make sure we're in the right order here. Yep, object weapon, object with which the weapon is colliding, X position of the impact, the Y position of the impact. Yeah, object enemy. And yeah, I'm basically just going to leave those alone. Same check, exposition. I've pulled in the wrong thing here. DS map value. Is it value? DS map find value. I had the wrong method there. So there we go. Good there. Y position. I got some early sketches for the cockroach animation. Looks awesome. Sweet. Argument 4, this one will be the sound of the impact. Just needs to check for the Y position. We'll call this impact sound. Impact sound. X position 2. Same thing for this, Y position 2. And man, I feel like I'm missing some or something here. Weapon, object with which weapon is colliding. The X position and the Y position, the impact sound, X position, Y position 2. Sound 2 and impact 2. Okay. Now, I did see something that I might want to change based on how everything was functioning yesterday. Not entirely sure yet. I meant to turn this back on here. Sorry guys, give me one sec, just changing some settings. Cool. All right. And, I think let's just leave it alone at that for a minute. Did I miss anything? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Nope. This last one here doesn't count for anything. So, yeah, I've got everything the way I want it right there. DS map add. DSWM. And probably what I'll do, guys, is... I'll have another script where all these settings are sitting, and I will just call out to creating a map in particular, returning it back, and then passing that into the collision script. So that's probably the way I'm going to do it initially. So script weapon collision is good there. And I basically have to do all these at once. Yeah, I mean, basically, when you start, you know, recreating or duplicating code is really when you want to go back and create some scripts. So I know I'm going to duplicate some code here, but I will write it first, and then I'll take it over to a script just to make sure I get all this mapped out exactly how I want to. So instead of Object Enemy 3, we're going to work on number 2 now. It's a little bit simpler than number 1. So 2, the X position will be X plus random range 10, 20. The Y position will be Y. And the last piece that we're going to add is the impact sound. Remember, we set the key on the other one to IS, sound, explosion, meet small, and then call this key impact sound. I think we're good with this guy. So then we just call out to the script weapon collision and pass in, since we overwrote the variable here, we can just pass in DSWM again. And then then we'll just do one more of these for the very last one, for the very last enemy. And so we can comment this guy out now, and we're working on this last one right here. So instead of object enemy 2, it'll be enemy 1. X plus 15 will be the correct value to pass in. I think I am missing a parenthesis on the one up above. Let me see. Yeah. X plus 15, Y position. Then we go sound explosion meet small. Sound explosion meet small. And object explosion bullet impact. So this one will be the impact effect 2. That's how we set it over there. And instead of rewriting it, I'll just copy what I got here. I think that'll do it. Pardon me. And I'm going to put a separation in between each one of these. Make it a little more obvious. And then what I'll probably do, guys, is just take a script, take these out and put them into a script where I'm just calling out to exactly which one I want to check against. What it will do is return the data storage weapon map, data structure weapon map, and then pass it off to the script weapon collision. So, because again, duplicating code, or coming fairly close. I mean, there may be a point where you just have to rewrite some of it, but I think I can reduce some of the way this is working. So the next step here, based on the way we have it, is to check and see if we got everything correct, everything mapped out correctly. I think we're in a good spot here. Let's go over and check the game and see if we're able to move to taking that data structure map out to a different script, and that won't be but a couple minutes. I got to turn full screen back on.
Mission 1. Death at dusk.
Yes, everything works. See if all the other enemies work as well. Yep, that works. Running a little slow. I'm not sure why. It might just be because I'm streaming at the same time. Game Maker might have some issues. I know what the problem is. We need to destroy the map as soon as we're done with it. I think Game Maker is creating a map and holding it in memory every single step. So let's look up that and write that real quick. It's not going to be hard. I think it's just DS map destroy. It destroys a map, permanently removing it from memory. We want to do that every time through the loop, because basically what happens is once you create a data structure, it ends up taking up memory. So even though we're overwriting it, let's go ahead and destroy it. DS map destroy DSWM. And yeah, I think that'll be good the way that is. Let's try it one more time, see if we don't have any slowdown. But everything worked exactly the way we wanted it to, guys. This is really good, because now we can pass in infinite number of parameters into our function, our script. Let's go ahead and make it full screen real quick. And actually, I think I'll just set up a toggle for full screen. We'll say full screen is false by default, or full screen is true by default. And we'll set up a toggle in here. Chris, can you give him our Skycurser YouTube channel? Hey, Victor Davian, how you doing, man? If global dot, sorry, if key pressed, nope, check released. I think we're going to do key check released. This will mainly just be for me. Let's go ahead and put this where our global keys are so that I can just call it the same way I do everything else. I believe we have them in helpers. And we will go to script. Let's see. Screen shake, boot directories, reset game, update controls. Here we go. So, arcade platform, keyboard platform, disable. Okay. Arcade dot key full screen equals ORD. I'm just going to make up something here, Chris, if you're watching. Let's say 9. And then do the same thing down here for keyboard. Except instead of 9, it's actually going to be just Y. And I'll also go key full screen released. Okay, perfect. I'm just working on a quick toggle for full screen or not full screen, instead of having to go in and change a setting every single time. This is going to be specifically helpful whenever I'm just doing some debugging, Chris. Keyboard check released. And this will be global dot key full screen. I just created that. And then we'll go window. I think it's set full screen. Nope. Full screen. Nope. Give me the freaking variable. Set full screen. Yeah, I was close, but didn't have it all the way. Set full screen. Not variable, but function. And then set it to... we're going to check and see what the current full screen is. I think we can go window get full screen. Window get full screen. going to update a setting really quick. Switch to that. Apply. Okay, cool. So I just updated a setting so that every time I get out of the game, it switches back to show the webcam. So sorry that I keep letting the webcam cut out for you guys. I wanted to check the... yeah, get full screen, pass in a key. The key to check the release, no, that's wrong. Click on it first. If window, get full screen. Yeah, so it just returns true. If window, get full screen. Then the answer is, yes, it is true. It is on, so set it to false. Else, set it to true. So I should be able to toggle in and out of full screen now without any problems. And that will just be based off the key that I just set. And so let's go ahead and try that. But I mean, I'm only going to try it making sure that everything else works. The main thing that I was going to do is make sure that we didn't have any problems with our DS map destroy. And I do want to make sure I've turned off the toggle from here. Yep, I have. Let's play. According to your schedule, the stream is up pretty early. Will you still be running until the scheduled end time? Yeah, I mean, I'll be pretty close today to that. And I try to stick to it as much as I can. I have to miss a couple days here and there, and sometimes I start a little bit later than 8 when I do start. So usually I start at 8:30. Today was a little bit unique in that I got to start a little bit earlier than normal. So we are on Eastern time here. So okay, I have an error. Shouldn't be that hard to fix. It doesn't like the. See, it doesn't like my variable line 4, so I've got to take this out of here because this keyboard variable is not set yet. So let's take it out of here and put this over in the persistent controller, because we run I know for sure we run the keys inside of the boot menu or inside of the menu. Let me see. So I'm just going to drop this right here and put a note. Oh, Victor, I see that you followed. I didn't hear the sound of my headset. So thanks a lot for following, man. Keyboard. Thanks a lot, man. Appreciate it. Yeah, It's myself and 3 other guys, me, Chris, and Phil, and so we're 3 indie devs working on Skycurser. So thanks for your interest, man, and thanks for the follow. Keyboard, let's say toggle full screen, and I could probably just put this into a script and then call the script from there, but that's fine right now the way it is. Let's cancel out of this error, hit play. So we'll have access to it once it gets into the menu. But on the boot up screen, it'll be full screen for now. I think Y is a good key for me right now, just because I can basically think, yes, I want full screen, or no, I don't. Got a lot of other keys taken up. Go full screen, not full screen.
Skycurser, okay. Mission 1. Death.
If we have any slowdown here.
Go.
I think we're pretty good. The slowdown is not existent compared to what it was a second ago. So the data maps are getting destroyed properly. We're doing some garbage collection basically. Cool. All right. Like it. okay, now we're going to take this over to a script and basically just have a switch case to set very specific things that we need to set for this, and everything will flow through there, we'll pass it into here, and then we'll destroy it afterwards. So this will be really good and will not take long to update. So we're just going to put this inside of Skycurser weapons. I know I have a DS map helper here because I just saw it a second ago and I set this up a little bit ago. So let me see what this is. String to add. Oh, so this was only to do some of my own global debugging. So I'm going to walk away from that. And I don't even think I'm using that anywhere. So script, weapons, and let me think for a second. Yeah. So we'll just say script, DS, weapon map, generate, and we'll pull in these guys right here. All of these, and we'll just have to kind of look and see how we want to do this right here. We know for sure we're going to return the DS weapon map, so we can go ahead and write that. The next thing that we want to do is set variables, I think. So I'm going to have these are going to be at the bottom, and we're going to have a switch case. And we'll pass in argument 0. We'll pass in two things. One will be the weapon, argument 0 and argument 1. The other one will be the enemy. Sorry. can't do it like that. Still thinking for a second. We're going to pass in... we still are going to pass both of them in, but we're not going to pass them into the switch statement. Can't do that. Script, DS. Okay. So argument 1 will actually be the weapon. And we'll go ahead and set that right here. We'll say argument 0. I said argument 1, but I meant basically the 0 index. Pardon me, I've just got to clear my throat, man. Okay, so from here, we'll set up cases, and they will basically be based on what enemy we're passing in. I'm just going to try to do it straight up off the... No, I can do it off of a string. I'll just set it up. I'm going back and forth in my head. Let's try to do it just straight up off the object. And so from there, we can set everything inside of here that we need to set. And so I'm also going to set some variables. So let's set our own custom variables, and they'll be... DSV1 for DS value 1. We know for sure we can just set this guy right here and this guy based off of the arguments that were passed in. So argument 0 and argument 1, but we're going to set some other variables. So XPOS will be x plus 15. Sorry, it'll be 0 initially, and then we'll override it inside of the switch case. 0 on the y position, impact sound, I'll just say 0 for now. Yep, so var DS4 V4 equals value 4 is the bullet impact. And we'll just say 0. We're just going to basically instantiate the variables right there. And let me check something real quick. Okay, cool. And impact sound and impact effect. I thought I had two more, you know, basically with this one. This is object enemy 1. I must have missed a couple of things here, which makes sense to me because I felt like I was missing a couple sounds when I played that a second ago. Let's just make sure we get this right. So impact sound, then we need xpos 2, xpos, ypos 2. So I missed a couple, but everything should still work just fine. DSWM, and then we'll say xpos 2 here, and that was x plus random range 10, 20, and dsmap add DSWM, ypos 2, and y, and I think that solves it right there. So over here, where I'm basically mirroring this and will remove it from my step, I will add those in. So let's add those in real quick. Right here, dsmap add, and those are going to be, let's write what these are real quick. DSV1 is xpos1, xpos2, sorry, ypos2, and this is the impact sound. This is the impact effect 2, and var dsv5 equals 0. And I'm actually going to change this from impact effect 2 to xpos 2. That's ypos 1, and this one is ypos 2, and this one is sound. We have IE2. Let me look at this one more time. Impact effect 2. So we've got sound of impact 2. So we're missing sound of impact 2 after position 1 and 2. IS2. And then this one was sound explosion meet small. Boom. Okay. Just don't want to miss anything here. DS, where are we at? IS, so X position 2. Let's keep going here because this is the most beneficial place for us to work. IS2 var DSV7 equals 0. And let me make that a little more clear. Impact sound 2. And this is impact effect 2. And you'll notice I'm not passing in an impact effect 1 because that was already in the script. But I may change that up. I'm not exactly sure yet. I may not even want to use that impact effect at all. So I may end up passing a variable in and rearranging the way some things are. Not a big deal though. So the main thing though was just to get this in place. Now we can basically say DSV1 here equals for object enemy, we can say x plus 15. So we're doing some hard coding here, but that's perfectly fine because we've reduced a lot. DSV2 equals the y position. DSV3 equals value 3 is the sound explosion meet small. I think that's the sound, right? Impact sound, yep. And then we had DSV-4 for enemy one. 4 was exposition 2. And that is X plus random rage 1020. I'm looking right here for that. And so let's do that. X plus random range 1020. DSV-5 equals Y. DSV-6, data structure value 6, equals sound explosion meet small. And DSV-7 equals object explosion bullet impact. Okay. That's all we had, because I know that we had 9 variables earlier, 0 through 8, but we've removed 2 variables by just letting those be the arguments that are passed in, the weapon and the enemy that is connecting with the weapon. So we start here, we could just go DSV-1, DSV-2. I'm debating in my mind, should I start at a 0 index? I'm going to say no for now, because it's a variable and not a an array. I'm just going to start with the index basically being 1. So this should be DSV3. We'll verify that that's the sound. Yes, it is. And you want 4, 5. And this will be X POS 2. This will be Y POS 2. And the next one will be IS 2, Impact Sound 2. And we'll change these value numbers, IE 2. And the last one should be DSV-7. Perfect. I don't need these anymore because we're inside of the script that has everything spelled out. I will spell out what argument 0 is. Argument 0 equals the object weapon. Argument 1 equals the object being collided with which the weapon is colliding. Okay. So we're in a really, really good spot here. Now all we have to do is duplicate what we have here and modify what we're going to pass to these to the data structure as it gets created here. If something does not exist, we're going to check for that. If something's undefined, basically. And, yeah. Okay. We have 0 here. It's going to be hard to check for undefined here if we have these set by default. I'm debating in my head whether or not I should instantiate them here. It doesn't matter for this moment. Let's finish what we know we can finish real quick. Mainly because I just want to only write, you know, some of these items here if we want to write those items. And the problem is that some of these are probably going to, the values of some of these could be 0, like the X position 2 or the Y position 2 or the X position 1 or 2. And if I'm checking to see, I can't just, you know, if I don't define them right here, I can just check to see if is undefined down here. But if I leave them at 0, I can't necessarily check to see if it's 0 because that may be a valid value. So that's kind of what I'm going through in my head. But I can keep moving forward right here. So I'm going to keep moving forward until I need to make a decision. So on Object Enemy 2, which is right here, I'm pulling this over to this script. We can now say we're passing in v1, v2. Value 1 is going to be x plus random range 10, 20. Y is going to be y. Impact explosion. Impact sound is going to be sound explosion. Meet small. And that looks like that's it for that one. There's only 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 values that need to be set. So those other two values are set by the arguments that are passed in, so we only need 3 here. Additionally, let's go up here. I think we only need 1, 2 values here because the other two are default. And so let's just see what we have here. This one will be the only straight up X for enemy 3, Y for value 1 for enemy 3, Y for value 2 for enemy 3, and that should be it. Okay. Am I allowed to set null? Does GameMaker have a null value? Null? Don't see anything for null. How about nil? Nothing for nil. This is off. Nothing for null or nil. I'm going to do a quick look up on Google to see if there's a way to set a value to null, because I would rather check for a null value. Maker variable check for null value, or create, sorry. Yeah, how to define a null variable. This is perfect. Well, what if 0 is a valid value? How about negative 1? I guess negative 1 could be a valid value as well. I could set them as a string to null. Those would definitely, like, I don't know where I've ever set anything to null when it doesn't need to be. So I'm going to do probably something a little bit out of the norm here. I don't like the fact that X position here and Y position here could basically be a zero value, but I don't want to set them unless I need to set them. So I'm going to say here, if DSV4 does not equal null, then we can proceed. If DSV5 does not equal null, then we can proceed. Yes, this is not from the playbooks here. I mean, I don't like setting a string to null, but it doesn't look like GameMaker has like a value that I can set as like not having a value other than to leave it undefined, and I don't necessarily think that's a good idea, because then I would have to basically say var on every single one of these items here, right? Just set var all the way down. Why do that when I only need to really set it once, right? And that's all in one place up here. DSV7 does not equal null, then set it. Okay, we're going to leave it like that for a moment. We've got everything set right there. We're in a really good spot. We no longer need to do any of these. So basically now we can just call the script. And the script is called script ds weapon map generate, and we're just going to pass in two values. One will be self. It's the argument that's getting passed into this step event. Yeah, so this will probably be migrated to a script later, and we'll end up calling argument zero instead of self later. But for now, it is self because it's referring to the object mini blast bullet. And then argument one will be the object we're checking against. So just check for enemy one. And we're creating a DS weapon map from the return value here, right? And just say var, pass it in. It gets sent into the weapon collision, and then it gets destroyed on the next location. Okay, we're doing good here. This is really good. Okay, do the same thing here. And guess what? All we gotta do is put enemy two here. And then one more thing, which is this guy, and call enemy three here. Now, if we did this correctly, this should all still work just fine. And guess what? We got some duplicate code here, so that means we can make one more script and just pass in the argument. We'll probably pass in two arguments to the script that we call. It'll be self and object enemy one, but yeah. That must be either one old Linux distribution or a really old skin. Referring to Button Masher. Button Masher, yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Arcade player. Right here. You talking about the program that I'm building in? This is Game Maker Studio Professional. Doesn't look as slick as Unity or Visual Studio, but it does the job. Nope, no Linux. Hey man, how's it going? Not Linux, Windows for sure. Windows. Yep. All right, so this is a really good spot. Let's check our work by just hitting start. Looks like we have an error. Got, I missed a close parentheses, thumbs up, play again, try again. Here's our compile window. Load them up, Game Maker. Go.engine, nice. So how did you get started with Go.engine, Button Masher?
Mission one, death at dusk.
Got a bug? No worries. Copy it, abort. Part of the process. Alright, I misspelled something right here for value 6 on line 21 of our script. So let's go look at our script real quick. No big deal at all. Sound. Boom. Got it. Thumbs up. Play again. I don't know if you watch Wilkie as one of the other programmers. I think he uses Go.engine. Saw the article on Pharonix of its release and tried early on to get involved. It's got a decade worth of work into it from OKM Studio. It was their internal product for their contract game development. They open sourced it. Tight. That's really cool, man. I'll have to read up on it.
Mission one. Death at dusk.
Got another bug. Totally fine. Invalid comparison type. Looks like I accidentally put that in the wrong place. I see what the problem is. It's showing me that DSV4 not equal null doesn't have a space in there, so I think that's an easy fix. Just got a follow. Thanks, Button Masher. Appreciate it, man. Thanks for the support. Here we go. Hmm. I thought that's what I saw there. DSV4 does not equal... No, it doesn't like me checking for the null keyword, the workaround that I had in place. Got another follow. Problem solva. Thanks a lot for the follow, man. Really appreciate it. Thank you for the support. So if you're just tuning in, I tried to come up with a workaround. GameMaker doesn't really have a value that you can set when you want something to be null and you're just instantiating it. And I don't think I can just go var ds4 like this. Based on some of the way that they just recently updated some things. I mean, heck, I'll... Well, no. I just don't want to repeat the var keyword all the way down. That's the main thing I'm trying to check for. I'm just going to... Gonna give GameMaker a hard time here. Maybe they just have something against the keyword null. New with GameMaker, huh? Yeah. You just get started using it. Working on a new project. So we're booting back up here. Let's watch our compile screen. See if we fix it.
Mission 1. Death at dusk.
Nope. No fix. Copy. Abort. I'm shocked here. What am I doing wrong? DS version 4. Yeah, working on RPG tutorials mostly, though. Yeah, I had to watch a lot of tutorials and read a lot of documentation. Not to like the type. Yeah, I know. It doesn't like the fact that I'm checking for a string here. But I think it maybe has a problem with the fact that I'm setting it to a string here and then in some places changing it to an integer, or in the case like an asset, sound explosion meet small object explosion bullet impact. Single quote strings, I mean, I can try that. I mean, heck, I'll try it real quick for the heck of it. I don't think that's it, though. I think I'm gonna have to say, I think I'm going to have to set whatever the type is. I think I may just have to set them to 0. But again, I think that's flawed if I have to do that, because I could have a valid X position of 0 or Y position of 0. And I need to do this check here. I should have changed this as well. Yeah, I think that's what it is. It's having problems every time it comes back here. Or it could, I mean, it could basically have a problem right here where it's basically, oh, I'm an integer now, and then I'm checking to see if this is a string. You know, it wouldn't hurt to... set this to 0, but I gotta check my collision script real quick and see if that's okay that I can do that. I mean, I'm basically setting them to false. I'm setting everything else to false. The sound and everything. I mean, I could set them to false because Yeah, I mean, false is working correctly right here where I'm doing it there. So that's what I'll do. False. Sorry, I'm just going to go straight for it because I know. I'll do the not is undefined check for DSV4 here and DSV4. Because if this is false, then it won't get passed here, but if it's not false, it'll get passed there. Come on. 7. All right. Let's try this one more time. Switch statement seems to come before the null check. Let me look at that. Well, yeah, it basically has to because I'm basically seeing if I've changed the values there. I think this might work. Let me just see if it does. About to find out.
Mission 1. Death at dusk. Go!
Yes. Okay, perfect. That does work. So false is the trick. Make sure it's not undefined, which it should never really be undefined. So I think we're good. Let's try leaving it like that. And we got one more script to write, guys, which is just the, notice how we have some duplicate code here. We're trying to reduce and remove where possible. It's just part of the process. Create script. Script. Collision. Check. I don't know if I like that. I mean, I've got weapon collision and collision check. Collision gen. Let's try that. I mean, it's basically what we're doing here. And we'll just call script collision gen orator. Argument 0 will be the weapon. Argument 1 will be the object with which the weapon is colliding. Okay. Grab this. And I think that's all we got to do is just leave it like that. Minus this guy, argument 0. And this guy, argument 1. And I think we are done. So we simply call script collision gen. Did I spell that right? Ah, missing out parentheses. Boom, boom. 2, 3. Done. Guys, look at that. Look how clean that is. Man, Okay, so we're good, we're good. Reduce, remove. So I'm reading what you said here. Weird that a string doesn't work, but a bool does. Nice. Did you make the sprites yourself? Problem Solva says. No, I didn't make the sprites myself. I think Chris is still in here. Chris is in chat as Skycurser. And my username is SkycurserDev. So Chris is one of the other two indie devs on this project. Chris is the art director and the sound engineer. So he's done all the music, all the sound effects. And then Phil is the hardware guy. So if you've gotten a chance to read about our project, we're working on a really cool project, guys. We're working on our game is going to be exclusive to the arcade. And we've gotten a chance to demo our game. We've got level one all but complete. It's basically playable all the way playthrough on level one. And we've gotten really good feedback. We've gotten to take it to several different locations. Yeah, I work on a small team. We're a team of three, and we build all this in our free time. So been working on it for a little bit over a year, and we think we're probably going to finish by next February. So short deadline, but we're going to have at least five levels built in, maybe more, but it just kind of depends on how the story works itself out. And yeah, indie for the win. That's right. All right, so we are in good shape here. We no longer need this information up here, guys, because we verified that this works inside of our script weapon collision. Yeah, and so I think we're at a good point here. I do want to make some progress, and that is to pull over a couple more items into our collision checker. So let's look at this real quick. I think it's the DS weapon map generate. This is the key right here. This is where we're going to put all of our variables. So the main thing is I just need to make sure that all these are filled out where necessary for each of the objects. So I'm going to just stub out what I have real quick. Object enemy 4, break. Oh, I'm reading button masher real quick. I knew I missed something. So if it is using lazy instantiation, the switch is where the value is being referenced, which then sets the dynamic type, ignoring the initial assignment. But that doesn't explain why the Boolean works. Oh, well. Yeah, I think the Boolean evaluates to true if it's got a value set for it. So that's generally the way things... I feel like that's generally the way things work in programming. If you've set a value to a variable and you try to check and see if it's true or false, it will evaluate to true. If it's not, it's usually like if it's not null or undefined or set to false or zero, generally it will evaluate to true. So I think that's why that works in that case, because it gets past the Boolean because it says, oh, this is true. Otherwise, literally, it is written as false. All right, 4, 5, 6, 7. Let's go look at how many enemies we have real quick. Level 1 through 5, 6 and 7, and then we have. Means to some languages where booleans are static types in themselves and can't be type coerced that way, like Golang. Yeah, man, Golang. Golang is really tight. I like Golang a lot. Yeah, I've had to work with Golang at work. All right, so we're looking at the obstacles, and we're looking at level 1. So we've got two more enemies to drop here. Necrostar 1 and 2. I think that's it. And then we've got an enemy on level 2 right now. So 4. This guy should be 5. This guy should be tank 1, object enemy, sorry, object tank one. I feel like I'm missing one though. What's enemy five? Yeah, where's my carrier? Oh, that is the carrier, okay. But there's an actual tank too, so I've got to include that. Let's look at the boss. Boss has object and object boss one tank and object boss one tank drop. So I know those are three more that I have to add. One, two. Yeah, maybe two more. Okay. Tank one, object boss one, object boss one tank. Object boss one tank drop, and object necro star one, object necro star two, and I know there's got to be a couple more in here. Look, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, tank one, boss one tank drop. Necrostar 1 and 2, I'm pretty sure we've got, like, boss orb, object boss 1, attack orb, and then we've probably got a couple more here, so give me just a second, guys, while I look these up. Oh, the Heli Wolf, let me take this guy up near the boss. Object Heli Wolf. That's on level 2. And I think I've got one more, but I'm not going to worry about it right now. Okay. So, I wanted to pull one or two more in, and we could verify them real quick. These ones look really small here. I guess I have a couple of vehicles that I could pull in. Yeah, at least a vehicle. So, let's add in the object-based vehicle. Vehicle, and the heli's real simple right now. We don't have any sound effects on that, but let's check the boss one tank and the tank drop. Let's try to pull these in real quick. So, let's make sure we do this correctly. Pull that guy there. Oops. Right there, and then pull this guy right here. So we'll do boss one tank, and our positions need to be X and Y position. DSV1 equals X, DSV2 equals Y, getting that from right here and right here. And then beyond that, we've got V3 for the sound. DSV3 equals sound impact metal. And this is the place where I felt like I might need to redo the impact sound, object explosion bullet impact. Actually, I don't need to worry about it because I'm basically setting it here. Let me see. Well, I may need to do the bullet impact inside the weapon collision. Yeah. I'll come up with a short stop real quick on that. So we're down here, sound impact metal, DSV4, and I'm not going to pass this in at the moment because I'm going to have to rework some of my variables up here in order to do this correctly. So let's try this, but let's first go edit the script. Weapon attack and weapon collision. This is where all the magic happens with everything that we're passing in. The final choice on this one, I'm going to do something a little bit different here. And this will be the normal location of collision. This is the split the collision for the enemy in two. Okay. All right. So we'll do an elsif right here. Elsif object get name of arg1 is equal to object boss one tank. Let me make sure that's right. Object boss one tank. So I'm working not in the boss's tank, but I'm working in the tank that we're referring to as a carrier. So we kind of treat this guy like it's a tank, but it's just, it tanks a lot of bullets, and the boss one tank is actually a tank. So I need to make sure that I say that here, object boss one tank, and then instance create arg2, arg3, and then instead of these two, we're going to have, I think, the object explosion. Let me look what arg8 is. Arg8, in that case, for enemy 1, well, enemy 1 had that many arguments. I don't want to pass in that many arguments, so I'm just going to pass in the actual, this is a stopgap. I'm going to have to definitely fix this later, but this should pull everything in correctly for that enemy. We'll do the same thing with the tank drop. So, object boss 1 tank, object boss 1 tank drop. Everything looks actually exactly the same. Object explosion, bullet impact, sound impact, metal. X and Y position, X and Y position. So literally I can take all of this, drop it here, and then do another OR right here. OR boss one tank drop. And so this will handle both. So we're going to go to the boss on level 1 and shoot at the tank when he picks the tank up and see what happens when the Vulcan cannon bullet hits the tank on either the, when it's in the boss's mouth or dropped from the boss. So let's go do that real quick. Thumbs up. We pulled in two more. If this is the case, we can take this out and we can take this out. But we also have to make sure that we pass in everything correctly here. Remember, we added this for a reason. Object boss one tank, tank drop. Okay, play, see what we got. Okay, here we go.
Mission 1. Death at dusk.
Got a bug. Let's fix the bug first. Illegal access of argument. Argument and argument 1. Copy this guy. Board. Take it over to the IDE. It doesn't like that we're trying to... Let's see. Called from line 1, step 1. Argument is not provided to script. So script DSWMGen should be passing it back. Let's verify this. This was what we just narrowed down and pulled into. So, argument is should be 0. Argument 0. So, fixed. Play again. Got to go soon. It's 4 a.m. here. Well, you can real quick. It'll take less than a couple minutes, and you're up late, man. Where are you at? Where are you from? Sounds like Europe, at least.
Mission 1. Death at dusk. Go!
Okay, so we're just going to make sure these first three enemies work correctly. They do. And then we're literally just going to fast forward to the end of this level so we can get to the boss and check the weapon that drops. Oh, we got a bug. Bullet impact. Let's copy it. So we didn't get past it. Had something arise. Let's see what it is. It doesn't like the fact that it couldn't find bullet impact for hit 5. Ah. So that code that I took out still needs to exist for all the other enemies until I can get all the other enemies updated. So we'll pull that code back in. And that should be a quick fix. Pull it back into the step. Drop it up here at the top. Okay, play. Test room with quick console. Netherlands, bro. Wow. Cadrius, I'm not exactly sure what you're referring to. My test room is my game, so if there's a better way to do it, I'm open. I'm all ears.
Mission 1. Death at dusk.
Bug. Ah, okay. Sorry, guys. Working these bugs out real quick before we can hit it. Okay. Try again. Play. Empty room with a plane. Text box with function like spawn and object name, which can be used to test making bosses or enemies quicker. Yeah, I mean, makes sense. I'm not sure. Off the top of my head, how that would be more helpful than how I have it right now, other than to get to that enemy quicker. I know what you're saying in terms of that, but I'd have to think of the specific use case for that.
Mission 1. Death at dusk. Go!
Okay, I'm just going straight to the boss. Looks like the bullets are working on everything they should be so far. Go check the boss tank. Okay, we just somehow it's got me going back and forth between full screen and not full screen. So there was a problem. When you get to the boss, we basically disable all controls, and it didn't. It kept releasing. That's what the problem was. Remember how we added that key in? Yeah, what the? Okay, hold on a second, guys. I'll get this really quick. Helpers, update controls. Don't release the key because it's basically just flipping back and forth. Okay, play. Sorry about that, guys. Let's just rush back to the boss. Here we go.
Last year, a
Mission 1. Go straight to the boss. Another bug. What the? It's, that should have been fixed. Sorry about that, guys. I think what I'll do is just disable the toggle right now. I mean, it's only a debug thing, so I'm just going to disable the toggle real quick. Controls. Should be in the persistent controller. Controllers, persistent, step, and just I'll get that fit working later and let it stay in. I'm just online on my phone so I can go sleep when I want. Haha. Nice. Ingenious. Android tablet. Alright, so as soon as I test this, guys, I think this is going to be it for tonight. We made a lot of progress. Now all we got to do is pass everything in to this guy, the DS weapon map generate, and then we have everything handled. We will have to modify our collision script slightly as we work on each of the enemies. But again, we're way further than we were.
Mission 1. Death.
Here we go. Okay, so at some point here, he's gonna go pick up a tank. He's gonna test what happens when that happens, when that occurs. Okay, so he's getting ready to go pick up the tank. We want to see what happens. Bug. Copy. Abort. So. Self, object boss 1, tank. Yep, everything's fine right there. And then it's trying to get the hit points of the tank. Right now the hit point, the tank doesn't have any hit points. So, never had to check for that on the tank because it wasn't going through the same script as everything else. So, let's just look for this real quick inside of the script. But yeah, this is part of consolidation. I mean, we gotta work these little things out like this and see what happens. It's trying to remove hit points. If not is undefined, hit.hp. So yeah, I think I'm going to call it right here because I think we're in a really good spot. We've written this piece right here. It won't try to remove hit points if hit points doesn't exist for the object we're colliding with. We may or may not want something to flash, so I'll probably have to do a similar thing right here. If not is undefined, hit.flashing, because not all objects are designed to flash, right? It looks like I missed a parentheses. Okay. isn't defined, hit.flashing equals true. Boom, I think that would basically do it. Let me see real quick. Otherwise, do everything else. What the heck? I'm going to go ahead and run to the boss one more time. And error or no error, this will be it for the night. So, yeah, thanks for tuning in, guys, on Skycurser Daily number 31. It's been a good stream.
Mission 1, Death at Dawn.
Okay, same thing, we're just going to fast forward to the boss. Okay, we're at the boss. Alright, problem solver. Yeah, I know you're on here just for a minute longer. Yeah, let's check. Another bug. Copy board. This one is still having a hard time with this. I don't think it should have errored out there. Personally, but I didn't write Game Maker. So, if hit points is not undefined, then run that. Otherwise, we're good. So, thanks, Button Masher. Yep, so we're in a good spot, guys. I don't exactly know what this bug is, but I mean, this is just part of, again, you know, if you've been watching the whole stream, you know, like, we're mashing all of these items into one collision script, and the whole purpose of it is to reduce duplicate code where possible, because we don't want to make an update in one place and then have to go make an update in two or three, or in this case we had like 17 copies of very similar code. So we don't have to go through and do that. We want to basically go and update everything in one place, one time. It's a little bit of work to get it all into one script, but it's well worth it, and it helps you troubleshoot much better. And yeah, so this is just kind of what we're working through right now. We're in a good spot. I'm really pleased with how it turned out tonight. So, guys, thanks again so much for the follows and the support. Your support is really very appreciated. So, I think since that's the end of the stream, I'm just going to head over to our intro-outro video and leave you guys with that. Thanks so much for the support, guys, and I will talk to you next time.
Thank you.